space is now being open to more people, right? You have these citizen and private astronauts. You have analog astronauts who are simulating missions on the ground. Let's also make it fashionable and open up space to a broader audience. And that's what this whole thing is about. My name is Sabrina Thompson, CEO and founder of Girl in Space Club, where we will be designing the first women's space travel suit.
An artist by nature, Thompson's apartment is littered with ongoing projects, from paintings to prints and even shoes.
I have my table set up where I can make art, I could paint, I could lay out designs. Like for instance here, I took a sneaker apart to make my own.
When she's not creating, Thompson works full-time as an aerospace engineer for NASA.
This is like just a constellation of spacecraft. And that little short animation just kind of shows how they all like move relative to one another. As a kid, all I wanted to do, or all I did actually, was make art, play basketball, and play with my Barbies. It wasn't until my 12th grade year in high school, when it was time for me to choose a college, that I found out what an engineer was. I was the valedictorian of my class, yet everybody knew where they wanted to go to college except for me. And so my art teacher helped me out a bit, saw my dilemma, and she suggested, why don't you try engineering? And so I asked, what is an engineer? So I did some research to find out, saw that it took a lot of physics, a lot of the sciences, a lot of the math. And so I asked my physics teacher and he's like, yeah, you should stick with art. And so, yeah, at that time, the type of kid I was, if you told me what like I couldn't do or if there was any sense that you doubted me, that was the thing that I would do. Hence, that's how I became an engineer.
After getting a bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering from Stony Brook University, Thompson went on to earn a master's in aerospace engineering from Georgia Tech. She joined NASA in 2010 and has been working with the organization for the past 12 years, designing orbit trajectories for space missions. Just last year, Thompson finished a second graduate degree in atmospheric physics from the University of Maryland, Baltimore County. But she never abandoned her love for art.
One thing that I do outside of NASA is I'm always coming up with cool ideas, like just making things from scratch.
Some of these creations may end up on Girl in Space Club's website. Thompson founded the company in 2018, though at the time it was called Launchpad. Under the direct-to-consumer fashion brand, the 37-year-old sells everything from t-shirts and jean jackets to books, backpacks, and even NFTs, all of which bring in about $600 a month. Additionally, Thompson says she makes about $2,000 a month from speaking engagements and workshops. But the company also has a nonprofit mentorship arm that's very close to Thompson's heart.
The way things work right now with space and everything like this is male-dominated, and maybe it'll always be. Girl in Space Club, it exists to inspire more girls to become tomorrow's innovators using art, fashion, and STEM. Our ultimate goal for designing this spacesuit is to add the fashion piece. The fashion piece is very important to draw more girls into STEM and to space, especially more girls of color.
Although women ages 25 and older now represent a majority of the college-educated workforce in the U.S., they still trail men in many of the STEM fields, particularly in engineering and computing jobs.
Let's stop trying to get a seat at the table. How about we get our own table and we sit at it?
For the better part of this year, Thompson's been designing the Girl in Space Club Everyday Flight Suit, which resembles a stylish jumpsuit. To get the word out, Thompson and her team thought about launching a Kickstarter campaign, but quickly shifted gears.
While I was working with folks to help strategize for the campaign, the idea of a spacesuit for women came up. And that's how like we started to think about it, and I'm like, that would be cool. And then I started doing the research, and I'm like, this is absolutely necessary. Like, it's not just cool, it's necessary. And so here we are.
Thompson says women have always been instrumental in designing spacesuits, even if they were not always meant to wear them. In fact, the company that made the original Apollo spacesuits was none other than women's undergarment maker, Playtex, also known as the International Latex Corporation, or ILC.
Spacesuits have never been designed with women in mind. I mean, you could think about the 60s when, you know, we were in the space race. There were women who were behind the scenes sewing the suits together, you know? But it was the guys who were out there going to space.
Thompson and her team at Girl in Space Club will not be designing the typical bulky white Michelin Man spacesuit that NASA astronauts wore on the moon or use on spacewalks today. This type of extravehicular spacesuit design, known as EVA, acts as a mini spacecraft, providing astronauts with oxygen, modulating their temperature, and protecting them against the extreme environment of space. Such suits take years to develop and can cost billions of dollars.
This suit is going to be for launch and entry, right? So it's inside the vehicle that you would wear this suit. This is a pressurized suit. So let's just say, like, when you're on an airplane and there's a loss in cabin pressure, those big yellow masks come down, this suit will pressurize, like, be pressurized to protect you in the same way.
A number of private companies have already shown off their own versions of in-vehicle spacesuits. For its suits, SpaceX turned to costume designer Jose Fernandez, whose movie credits include The Avengers, Fantastic Four, and X-Men 2. Meanwhile, Virgin Galactic designed its blue monochromatic spacesuits in partnership with sportswear brand Under Armour. But Thompson says there's room for improvement.
I think they're kind of basic, definitely very masculine, and they lack color. Like, to me, I would definitely make the suits a little bit more, like, you know, cool and fun to, like, look at. Maybe a little bit more sci-fi-ish, maybe. Or maybe a little bit more delicate. I'm not quite sure yet. In designing a woman's space travel suit, we would make the bust bigger, we would make the shoulders less broad, and then we would expand the hips.
Thompson's spacesuit design is still very much in its infancy. To help bring the project to life, Thompson is putting together a committee of aeronautic and fashion experts. Among them are former NASA astronaut Nicole Stoat and Patricia Stoll, who's the president of IOC Dover's Space Systems Division. The young women from Girl in Space Club will also play a key part in the suit's development. Thompson says she's not yet sure how much the final spacesuit will cost, but hopes to raise $75,000 from a month-long Kickstarter campaign, which launched on October 24th. The everyday flight suit will be available as a prize to those who contribute $600 or more to the Kickstarter campaign. She hopes the Kickstarter money is enough to cover the R&D and prototype portion of the project.
Just looking at history, a crew vehicle suit could cost in, like, the millions. We're definitely, you know, researching different fabrics, different material. We're gonna see how many parts that we can actually 3D print. So we're really trying to see where we can save and cut on costs. But again, that requires a lot of R&D and just understanding and knowing and just kind of doing our homework to know what has been done before us.
Right now, Thompson says she's deep into researching what patents have been filed that deal with spacesuit pressurization and trying to see if there's any new technology that her team can use to make their own pressurized suit. Once a prototype is ready, it will have to undergo rigorous testing.
If NASA's involved, meaning like these are suits that NASA astronauts will wear, then NASA dictates the safety, the testing, and the verification. However, if not, it's the FAA. Learning what those regulations are for the FAA, that will be one thing. Understanding what mission you're designing to, and this includes the level of exposure, or how long you're gonna be in space, what you're gonna be doing while you're in space. Are you going to be working? Are you gonna sit and take a ride, and is the ride only 15 minutes and then you're back down to Earth? Then the requirements and the testing will be different for a longer mission.
Thompson says designs also have to work with the specific launch vehicle.
For instance, if you're taking a ride with SpaceX and you're wearing their suit, they have a lot of integrated systems embedded in the suit that function with the actual launch vehicle. So to design a spacesuit for a particular mission, or for a particular launch vehicle provider. These are things that we have to take into account when designing the suit. Like, is there a way to make a universal suit? That's something we'll have to research and find out if it's possible.
The work ahead will not be easy, but Thompson likes a challenge.
I have become obsessed about this project, about this business. Let's go to space, let's make it look good.